Biology.
So welcome there to this class, whereby in this class we are going to study about biology from introduction to biology. So let's define biology. So what is biology? We'll say that biology is derived from a Greek word bios, which means life, and logos, which means knowledge. So therefore, biology is the study of life. So biology has different branches, whereby we have the main branches of biology, and then we also have the other branches of biology. So let's look at the three main branches of biology, whereby the first one, we have botany, whereby botany is the study of plants. Then we also have zoology, whereby zoology is the study of animals. Just from the word zoo is where animals are found. Now in biology, zoology is the study of animals. So apart from that, we have microbiology, which mainly encompasses the study of microscopic organisms. Now apart from that, let's now look at the other branches of biology, whereby we have very many other branches of biology. We are going just to look at a few. So the first other branch of biology, we have morphology, whereby morphology, this is the study of the external structure of living organisms. Example, we have feathers in birds, we have skin in human, we have hair in dogs, we have fur in a cat, we have also scales in fish, etc. So that is under morphology. So the next branch we have is anatomy, whereby anatomy is the study of the internal structures of living organisms. So apart from that, we have also physiology, whereby physiology, this is the study of the functioning of the different parts of the body. So apart from that, we also have another branch which is called biochemistry, whereby this is the study of chemical patterns and chemical materials inside of living organisms. We also have cytology, whereby cytology is the study of cells. We have genetics, which is the study of inheritance and variation. Ecology, which is the study of living things and their interrelationship with the environment. So how living things are interacting with the non-living things in the environment. We also have taxonomy, whereby this is the placing of organisms in groups of origin or ancestral origin. We also have histology, which is the study of different tissues. So not to forget that we also have virology, the study of virus, bacteriology, which is the study of bacteria, entomology, the study of insects, and ichthyology, which is the study of fish. So apart from that, let's look at the importance of biology. Now you see, the branches of biology will give you an importance of biology. Also looking at the topics in biology, so read a topic and say what you have learned on that topic is another importance of biology. Let's look at an example. So in physiology, we learn the different functioning of the we learn the different functions of the parts of the body, that is in physiology. So in cytology, we get to learn more about the cells. In histology, we get to learn more about the tissues. So those are among the importances of biology that are very simple for you to get. So also in biology, we get to learn more about genetics and inheritance. So also in biology, we get to learn more about living things, considering animals and plants. Biology is also a career subject whereby you will enter a career in medicine, in teaching, in nursing, in engineering, in farming, etc. Now for this point of a career subject, never mention that biology is a career subject and leave it hanging like that. So you must give examples of what career, because plumbing is also a career. If you study biology, you can never be a plumber. They are not compatible. So you must mention or you must give examples. So also in biology, we get to study the different functions of the circulatory systems in the body that we have. So first of all, let's look at the characteristics of living organisms. So the first characteristic of living organisms we have is nutrition, whereby this is the mode of acquiring and utilizing nutrients in the body. So the other characteristic is respiration, whereby this is the process where food is chemically broken down in the body to release energy. So that is respiration. So apart from that, we also have gaseous exchange, whereby gaseous exchange, this is the process whereby respiratory gases pass through respiratory surface. Never mention gaseous exchange is the process where oxygen is taking in and carbon dioxide. No, never mention that. So you must mention that is the process where respiratory gases pass through respiratory surfaces. Like the respiratory surface example, we have the lungs in mammals, we have the gills in fish, we have the tracheal system, we have the buccal cavity, etc., etc. So the other characteristic we have is excretion. So what is excretion? So excretion is the process whereby metabolic waste are removed from the body. That is excretion. We also have growth and development, whereby growth is the permanent increase in size and the development is the permanent change in complexity of the organism. Also not forget we have reproduction, whereby this is the process where mature organisms give rise to fertile offsprings. So never mention that it's the process where organisms give rise to. No, you must mention it's the process where mature organisms. So the organisms must be mature to give rise to fertile offsprings. We also have irritability as the other characteristic, whereby this is the process where organisms detect and respond to environmental stimuli using the nerves or the hormones, which we are going to look at in Form 4. So we also have movement and locomotion, whereby movement is the change in position of part of the organism. Like for example, the tree does not locomote, the tree only moves. Why? The tree is in static position, but it roots and the stems and the branches, they move from one place to another. So what is locomotion? So locomotion is the change in position of the whole organism from one point to the other. Now you see that the plants don't locomote because the plants can't change position of the whole body from this place to that place. But the roots, they move. So plants only exhibit movement, while animals exhibit both movement and locomotion. So let's look at some other differences apart from that. So what's the difference between plants and animals? So the first difference, you say that the plants have chlorophyll, while animals don't have chlorophyll. So in the cells of the plant, they have a cellulose cell wall, while the animals don't have a cellulose cell wall. So the plants also, they have a very simple excretory system, while the animals, they have a very complex excretory system. Also, don't forget that you say plants only move, while animals move and locomote. So also for the plants, they respond very slowly to temperature or environmental changes, while animals, they respond rapidly to environmental changes, that is under irritability. So for the plants, you see that growth occurs in the shoot and the root tips only, or in specific regions, while in animals, growth is throughout the body. So let's finish up by looking at the rules in drawing, because in biological drawings, there are rules for you to draw. So you can't just draw a diagram in biology. So the first rule is that you should never shade your diagram. So your diagram should never be shaded. So the second rule is that you should only use a very sharp pencil. Never use a dull pencil to draw in biology. So also in biology, you should never use a pen to draw. You should only use a pencil to draw. Also, you should never use a ruler, or you should never use a compass to draw in biology. All diagrams should be drawn using free hand. So after drawing a diagram, you should give your diagram a title. So your diagram must have a title. When labeling in biology, so all labels should be towards the right side. So all labels should be on the right side. Never label your diagram from all sides. It will be wrong. So always label your diagram on the right side. Also, for the labels, they should not be arrows, but they should be just a straight line touching exactly what is being labeled. Then finally, after drawing the diagram must be inside a table. So those are the rules to observe when making biological diagrams. So let's meet on the next class now, as we now begin discussing classification. Biology.